Hey guys, and welcome to this lesson. So in this lesson, I'm going to talk about server virtualization. Now, this is a technology that's been around for quite a long time, and it underpins the cloud. So services like Amazon EC2 leverage virtualization. So let's look at what it is in case you haven't been exposed to it before. So let's have a look at an example of a server when we're not using virtualization. Long time ago, we didn't have virtualization, so this is what we built. We had a server, which obviously has some hardware in it, and that hardware is composed of the CPU, the processor, we've got the RAM, the random access memory, we've got some storage, we've got a network adapter. There's other components as well, but these are the main important ones. Then we have the operating system. So this would be Linux or Windows or some other operating system. On top of that, we now install our application or our service. So this could be a web server, it could be a database server, it could be a file server, whatever it is, the service is running as well. Now, some of the limitations of this model are firstly, the operating system, the OS, is tied to the hardware layer. So there's tight integration between the operating system and hardware, meaning that it is not portable. It's not easy to move that particular operating system with its application to another piece of hardware if, for example, you need to perform some maintenance or maybe even the server fails. It often leads to underutilized resources, so we end up with lots of wasted capacity. It's just not a very efficient way of utilizing the underlying server. And that leads to higher costs, of course. And scalability constraints. So what if we suddenly need a lot more compute power? We either have to add that compute power to that underlying physical server. Maybe we have to literally open up that server, add in some memory cards, for example, or we have to find a way to get that operating system and application moved somewhere else. Unless we can scale horizontally, that's another topic. But this is a few of the limitations of using this model where we didn't use virtualization. And longer deployment times because we need that hardware layer, of course, as well. So then we move to a model where we have a virtualization layer. That is called a hypervisor. So we have our physical server, and then we have the hypervisor software on top. For example, VMware, we've got Xen, we've got KVM, we've got Microsoft Hyper-V. Those are a few examples of hypervisor software. So the hypervisor creates a layer of abstraction between the physical server and what runs on top, which is a virtual server now, also known as a virtual machine. The hypervisor allocates or emulates the physical resources to the virtual machine. So the virtual machine actually gets a subset of the resources that are available. Now we can have an operating system and a web service or whatever our application layer is within that virtual machine. Now virtual machines, virtual servers or instances, that's the same thing. It's just different terminology for the same thing. It's a virtual server running with an operating system on top of a hypervisor. Now, one of the great benefits is we can now run multiple virtual machines and therefore multiple operating systems and multiple applications on one underlying server. In fact, we can have many, many virtual machines. So for example, here we have a hypervisor and it's got lots of virtual machines. Every one of these could be running a different operating system and a different application, and they're all running on one server. We also have portability. So now these virtual machines can be easily moved between servers because they're not tied to that underlying hardware the way they are without virtualization. So we get quite a few benefits. The virtual machine is portable, we get better resource utilization, and therefore that drives lower costs. And we have great scalability as well. So now we can easily scale because we can add additional hypervisor servers underneath, and we can move our virtual machines around and provide the capacity to the virtual machines as we need. We have very quick deployment times. You want to launch a new server, as long as your underlying hardware infrastructure has the capacity, you can deploy them very, very quickly indeed. Okay, so that is server virtualization in a nutshell. Now, server virtualization has been around a long time. Around about 20 years or so ago, it became very popular. I spent many years migrating lots of physical servers to virtual machines, but now it's a very well-established technology. But the reason I need to make sure you understand it is because it does underpin the cloud. Lots of AWS services run on top of a hypervisor.